I am Dr. Nalini Avinash Vagmare. This is my brief information. Working as an assistant professor in history at the Maharashtra Vidyapeeth. Today's our topic is Shaivism. Shaivism, meaning of Shaivism. What we have to study in this lecture is meaning of Shaivism, various names of Lord Shiva, various sects in Shaivism, belief and practice of Shaivism, Shaiva temples in India, Shaivism contribution to Indian culture and literature, and conclusion. So those who follow the Lord Shiva, we call them as a Shaivite or Shaivas. So along with the Lord Shiva in this picture, we find the Lord Shiva, Parvati, Ganesh and Kartiki. There are many sources to understand this Shaivism. See, in India, Shaivism, Vaishnavism, Jainism, Buddhism, Shaktism, other religions are also there. For ancient Indian culture and literature, here we have to study the Shaivism. There are many sources to understand the Shaivism. No source, no history like that. Here, to understand Shaivism in detail, well manner, we have to refer the Vedas, Brahmanas, Upanishads, Puranas, epics, Bhagavad Gita, Agamas. Many sources are helpful to understand Shaivism in a different manner and in detail to understand Shaiva philosophy, religion, principles and practices. Now let's see the historical background of this Shaivism. Shaivism also we find in Indus Valley civilization. That time Lord Shiva was worshipped in the form of Pashupati. We also find call them a Pashupati Nata at that time. When Aryan period was there, in Vedic period, the Shiva was worshipped Rudra Shiva. Then in the later Vedic period, took place at that time, Shiva was with his family like Shiva, Ganesha and Parvati. And generally those who worship Lord Shiva is called as a Shaiva. Then Pashupati Shiva and Rudra Shiva, the Indus Valley and Vedic period. Then Hindu mythology gives us a lot of information about this Shaivism. In classical Hindu mythology, Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva are linked together as the gods of creation, preservation and destruction respectively. In the varied Shaiva versions of myths, however, Shiva is generally portrayed as the one god overall who is ultimately responsible for the creation, preservation as well as destruction. Vaishnava versions too, the same for Vishnu. This informal monotheism takes more systematic forms in the theological works of Shaiva and Vaishnava. Means those who believe the Lord Shiva, they called as Lord Shiva was the creator, preserver as well as destructor, and totally they believe in Lord Shiva. Those who follow the Vaishnava religion, Vaishnavis, they think that this world is created by Lord Vishnu and he was the creator, preserver as well as destroyer. So these things we find here. Then some dynasties which patronized this Shaivism. The coins and inscriptions that give evidence of Shaiva worship are plentiful from the period of Kushanas, 1st and 2nd centuries. And more important, that of the Gupta periods, they also patronized the Shaivism. Actually, the Gupta emperors mostly preferred the Vaishnavism. They also sponsored temples of Shaiva. They also patronized the Shaiva temples in India. The kings of the contemporary Vakataka dynasty were mostly followers Shiva, as were those of the slightly later Mokhari dynasty. They also patronized the Shaiva religion and patronized the Shaiva temples in India. From about the 7th century, Shaivism became the dominant religious current in the South, largely replacing the Jainas and the Buddhists and competing successfully with the Vaishnavas. The southern dynasties of Pallavas, Cholas, Chalukyas, where all patronized the Shaivism. Then Lord Shiva also worship in various form. In the Nandi form also Lord Shiva was worshipped. He is also worshipped till today. Then Shaivas various forms, Nataraja, Shivapinda or Shivalinga form also Shiva was worshipped in India and abroad also. Then Lord Shiva worship we find. Then various schools of Shaivism, early worship of Rudra. The Puranic Shaivism is popular worship of Shiva. Then non-Puranic Shaivism we find that Atimarga, Mantra Marga. In Atimarga, Pashupata Shaivism, Lakulisha Shaivism, Kalamukha Shaivism and Lingayatism. Mantra Marga, Kapalika Shaivism, Shaiva Siddhanta, Paula and Tira, Rika Shaivism found in Kapalika Shaivism. Then Aghuris, Shaiva Siddhanta, like this type, various schools of Shaivism we find in India. Then one example I am giving here, the Lingayatism, which was the founded by the Mahatma Basveshwar in 12th century in Karnataka. Here a brief information mentioned about the Basveshwara. He was a socio-religious economic reformer of the 12th century. Anubhava, he established the world first religious parliament, that is called Anubhava Mantapa, where the without considered caste community people all are enter there and get the religious and spiritual knowledge. He wrote so many vachanas under that, up to now 1148 vachanas which are written in Kannada language. This existing in Kannada language, and this was translated in various languages by the Basava Samiti of Bangalore and other mathas. His religion also called as Veerashaivism as well as Lingayatism. Those who wear the linga, we call them as a Lingayatism. Then Ishtalinga worship practiced by the Lingayat people. Then linga worship and linga wearing found in Lingayatism. This is the only example to understand the Lingayatism. Then the Lingayats also pronounce the Om Namah Shivaya mantra. It means homage to Lord Shiva. Then belief and practices of the Shaivism we find in detail. Shaiva centers around Shiva, but it has many sub traditions whose theological beliefs and practices vary significantly. Lord Shiva is called by various names like Shiva, Mahadeva, Maheshwara, Umapati, Bholenath, Shankara, Ishwara. Then historical background of while we studying the Shaivism in South India. By the 7th century, the Nayanas, a tradition of poet saints in the Bhakti tradition developed in South India with a focus on Shiva, comparable to that of the Vaishnava Alavars. The devotional poems of Nayanas are divided into 11 collections together known as Tirumurai, along with the Tamil Purana called the Periya Puranam. The first 7 collections are known as Thevaram and are regarded by Tamils equivalent to the Vedas. They were composed in the 7th century by Sambandar, Appar and Sundarar. Tirumalar, also splendid Tirumalar, the author of the Tirumanthiram, also spelled Tirumanthiram, is considered by Tattva Nanda to be the earliest exponent of Shaivism in Tamil areas. Tirumalar is dated as 7th or 8th century by Morinus Internis. The Tirumanthiram is a primary source for the system of Shaiva Siddhanta, being the 10th book of its canon. Tiruvagam by Manika Vagar is an important collection of hymns. Mainly saying is that comparable to this Shaivas, Nayanars are popularized this religion in South India in 7th century. Bhakti movement in South India, Nayanas, 7th century, they popularized this Shaivism. Then Shaktism, along with Shaivism, we also study the Shaktism. The goddess tradition of Hinduism called Shaktism is closely related to Shaivism. In many regions of India, not only did the ideas of Shaivism influence the evolution of Shaktism. Shaivism itself got influenced by it and progressively subsumed the reverence for the divine feminine, Devi, as an equal and essential partner of divine masculine, that is Shiva, the goddess Shakti. In the eastern states of India, is considered as the inseparable partner of Lord Shiva. According to Clonin Flood, the closeness between Shaivism and Shaktivism tradition is such that this tradition of Hinduism are at times difficult to separate some Shaiva worship in Shiva and Shakti temples. Then a seated Ardhanarishvara, symbolically representing the feminine Shakti as inseparable part of Shiva. The major Shaiva temples in India, Omkareshwara, Rameshwara, Puri, Taraknath, Varanasi, Khajuraho, Ujjain, Somnath, Dwaraka, Bhairavnath, Kailasa, Kedarnath, Chandranath, Kathmandu, Sri Shailam, Ellora. Then major Shaiva temples in India, Trimbakeshwar, Kashi Vishwanath temple, which is called pilgrimage temples for the Hindus. Then Ambarnath and Bhimashankar also. Then Mahabaleshwar and Mallikarjuna temples. Then Somnath and Kedarnath temples is also popular for these Shaivas. Then Bruhadeshwara and Lingaraja temples, photos also mentioned here. Then Kotilingeshwara temple. Then Shaivism not only in India, we also find Shaivism in the other parts of the world. Then Shaivism is a form of Hinduism. We see Shiva is the most important deity. In practice, there are different branches of Shaivism. Shaivism is common in India, Nepal, Sri Lanka, Malaysia, Singapore, Indonesia. Then now, what is the contribution of Shaivism to Indian culture and literature? See, if I want to thoroughly take the Shaiva's definition, sect, as well as their different practices of every sect, then different religious places of Shaivism, it will take a lot of time. So briefly, I explain Shaivism in brief in this lecture. So Shaivism contribution to when we study Indian culture. One thing is, it is the major religion in India. Second, many sects find in Shaivism, many religious followers of Shiva, their sect, still found in India. That is one contribution. Then the Shaivist literature is also, plenty of Shaivist literature available in various languages. I take the example of the Kannada language, Vachanas. Even you take the Tamil language, also Nayanar's literature in Shaivism, various it contributed to enrich the Indian literature. It is one contribution. And Shaiva temples all over India, even apart from India, in other countries also we find the Shaiva temples, which attract the tourists, pilgrimage people, religious followers, and many temples considered as a holy places of for the Hindus. That is also one more reason, this contribution to Indian culture and literature. And many practice and beliefs still today, from Indus Valley or Puranas period to till today, Shaivist followers found all over India and abroad. The belief and practices still exist. For example, in the Mahashivaratri festival, we practice where that time we worship the Lord Shiva and practice the fast that day and take the blessings of the Lord Shiva. Even spiritual material balance. So Shaivism also contributed to the Indian philosophy and religion to balance the spiritual and material life. That is the one contribution. And Shaivism also given the to moral character, truth, non-violence. Even Shaivism major contribution to gender equality. When we worship this Ardhanarishvara. At that time, it shows the gender equality. So these are the references I referred to prepare this lecture. R.G. Bhandarkar's Vaishnavism, Shaivism and Minor Religious Systems, Varanasi 1965, reprints also there. Then Bhattacharya Haridasa's edited book, The Religions, Volume 4 of Cultural Heritage of India, 1956. Dandekar are in Some Aspects of History of Hinduism, Pune, 1967. Then Dandekar are in Insights into Hinduism, Delhi. Conant, Vishnuism and Shaivism, A Comparison, London in 1970. So in this book, they have mentioned the detailed information about Shaivism and Vaishnavism. Why we study these religions? Because still these religions, followers are there, practices are there, belief is also there. Then how historically this religion exist and how ruler patronize this one and what good points we have to take from this studying religions. So this all purpose and how this religion contributed to enrich our Indian culture, practices, philosophy, literature, art and architecture. For that purpose we have to study this one. So thank you very much for listening my lecture.